What's up, everyone? If you're looking to build an e-commerce app with search capabilities, secure online payments, and interactive customer support, stick around. I've got you covered in this episode. Our guests are the co-founders of Access 79, from Jacksonville, Florida, Priyanka, and from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Gina. Before starting Access 79, Gina worked at Chanel as the Director of Communications, and Priyanka practiced law. They share a love of overpriced cocktails, but their true passion is making luxury jewelry more accessible online. Let's hear about what they want to build.
So essentially, we're trying to bridge the gap between shopping in-store and shopping online. So if you've ever shopped in-store for fine jewelry, it can be a really overwhelming, intimidating experience. Usually there's a commission salesperson following you around. It feels very high pressure.
I started sending jewelry to my customers. My great customers, I would just send them a box of jewelry to try. And what I found is not only did I make these customers happy, but I saw that my sales went up because I think the experience was so much better than the alternative that they were experiencing, which is shopping in store and shopping online.
A client comes to our site, they take the style quiz, we ask them for their email. It's a pretty abrupt experience. And frankly, we haven't got many of our clients digitally. Most of them are acquired through a high touch manner. So we know that to grow and to scale, we really need to improve the digital experience.
So we have gone out and figured out what our clients want, and we just need the technical expertise to help us do that.
Priyanka and Gina want to survey their customers to find out what jewelry they like. The survey results will provide tailored jewelry recommendations that are available for purchase. Customers can also set up a time to talk to a stylist. To build this app, you'll start with AWS Amplify. Amplify is an open source framework designed to simplify building web and mobile apps in the cloud. It allows you to take advantage of the cloud without having to know the names of the underlying services. I suggest using the AWS Amplify command line interface because it manages the cloud resources in your project. Amplify is going to provision the wiring for our backend logic, access to our database, storing our front-end code, and delivering content to customers. After you set up your application, you'll want to add authentication. Writing your own authentication code often leaves security vulnerabilities or is just too time-consuming. Cool thing is that Amplify has an authentication module that is quick to set up without compromising security. I highly recommend it. Solid gold. Now that we have authentication figured out, let's go back to building this application. Gina and Priyanka want to have a survey to understand the kinds of jewelry that their customers want. To create the survey functionality, you'll use APIs that interact with a database. First, create the API to get and store questions and answers with Amplify. Next, use AWS AppSync, since AppSync manages and synchronizes your data in real time. Amazon AppSync simplifies application development by letting you create a flexible API to securely access data from one or more data sources. Simply write the GraphQL queries and poof, AppSync takes care of reading and persisting data to Amazon DynamoDB, a NoSQL database. For DynamoDB, you'll use one table for more than one content type, so your jewelry, orders, and users will be in one table. If you like the sound of AppSync, don't worry. You can use it with all of the services in this architecture today. After a user takes the survey, the app will show them jewelry tailored to their interests. AWS Lambda will process the results of the quiz. Lambda is a serverless compute service that allows you to run code based on events and without having to manage servers. Not having to manage servers gives you a lot more time for drinking cocktails. With the results from the quiz, Lambda will make a request to Amazon Elasticsearch to get jewelry that fits the customer's criteria. Amazon Elasticsearch is a managed service of Elasticsearch, the open source search and analytics database. Elasticsearch achieves fast responses because it searches an index instead of the text directly. This is like retrieving pages in a book related to keyword by scanning the index as opposed to searching every word of every page. When configuring Amazon Elasticsearch, you'll partition your data into shards. It is important to set the shard count correctly. If you have less than 30 gigabytes of data in your index, I recommend using one shard. Now the customer has all the information they need to buy the necklace they love. The next part of building the application is to process purchases. You can also use AppSync to your back end with a Lambda resolver. All that means is that Lambda will handle the transaction. The API passes client-submitted purchase requests to a Lambda function. Our friends at Access 79 are currently using Stripe to process the customer's credit card. Whether you're using Stripe, another payment processor, or are processing payments yourself, you can use Lambda resolvers as the backend logic to charge the customer's credit card. Once the charge is successful, cha-ching, you can record the transaction in a relational database. To understand purchase trends, you'll want to run analytical queries against a powerful relational database. Amazon Aurora is a great choice. It is a highly scalable relational database, which you can use with AppSync. Next up, Priyanka and Gina want to give their customers the ability to chat with a stylist. AWS has two services that simplify making a chat app, Amazon Lex and Amazon Connect. Lex allows you to make conversational chatbots. With Lex's automatic speech recognition and natural language processing, you can gather as much information about what your customer is looking for before talking to the stylist. You can also use a bot to answer commonly asked questions, which means less wait times to talk to a stylist and happy customers. Amazon Connect will be the mechanism to facilitate a conversation with a stylist. Connect is a service that simplifies spinning up a contact center. I love that an assistant often overlooked configuration settings such as toll-free numbers for other countries, hours of operation, caller ID, and fancy hold music. When the customer clicks on the Contact a Stylist button, the application will make a call to AppSync and trigger a Lambda function that invokes Lex. Lex will gather information from the customer, and as soon as the customer is ready to talk to a stylist, Lex will trigger a Lambda function to pass along the details of their conversation to Connect, so the stylist has the customer's information. The next step is hosting your application. With the Amplify CLI, run the command add hosting, and it will load your app into an Amazon S3 bucket with Amazon CloudFront as the content delivery network for user access. CloudFront will speed up the delivery of your content to your users. And that's how you build an e-commerce app. I know we covered a lot, so let's have a nightcap. Let's do a recap. The Amplify framework is a quick way to build a cloud application. It provides you the tools to add authentication, databases, APIs, and backend logic. To collect survey information about your customers, use DynamoDB. Search functionality on your website will be powered by Elasticsearch. Record and analyze purchase transactions in Aurora. For customer support or a concierge service, create a chatbot with Lex. Amazon Connect gives you the mechanism to talk to a live person. All of the backend logic is made with Lambda resolvers. Use AppSync to connect all of these services together. Host your app in an S3 bucket with CloudFront as your CDN. And that's how you can build a luxurious e-commerce application. Thanks again to Priyanka and Gina. I can't wait to see you light up the jewelry industry. Now, it's time for you to build your e-commerce app. It doesn't matter when you start, as long as you just get started. Thanks for hanging out with me today. See you next time.